Hello, hello, thanks for tuning in. Okay, we are back at the Harbor Freight panels. This is going to be the 1 year review to see if these things have held up and if they're still putting out the rated power. They have been out in rain, snow, hail, sleet. They've fallen off of the small house here, the tiny house. They've fallen off face down. So they've been through a lot. And these are the two different kinds that they sell. I do believe that this is the older style one, and that's the newer style one with the more lines in it. But no damage, over a year out, there's no fading, nothing's going on. Like I said, they've fallen from about 15 feet face down onto some dirt, nothing happened. And it's about 12 noon. We got the sun. It's really bright up there, and right now we are checking this panel here, the newer style one, I believe. And like I said, this is coming up on a year of already having them, and if you see here, we got 80 watts coming in, so it's still 80% efficient after a year. 6 amps were the peak. So 87 watts were the peak. So almost 90% efficient still after a year. It's extremely good. I'm gonna go ahead and jack the power consumption up and see what happens. We'll bring it down into the 12 volt range and then turn it off and see what it spikes at. Cause it is going through a PWM controller, so it's not going to be exactly perfect. And as you see, it's starting to go back up. See, we're over 6 amps, so it is producing actually more than what the manufacturer states as far as amp wise goes. So we're over 80% efficient, going on 83%. It's phenomenal after a year of being out in the weather consistently. And all they were done is wipe them off. That was it for the test. And now we're in the PWM charge mode, and we'll let it go for a few minutes and see if we can get over that 87. Okay, I don't think it's gonna get over 87 watts peak, which is 87% efficient, which is still doing very good. And obviously, if the battery was drained down a little more and there was some more load on it, there's variables. And it's a lead acid battery. It's not really good solid hookup. I just threw it together just to check them. And we're getting, like I said, 87, almost 89 or 88 watts, which is out of a 100 watt panel. That's really good. So I'm going to go ahead and run it down a little bit more and go ahead and switch over to the secondary panel here, which again, I'll have to check, but I'm not sure which one Harbor Freight still sells. But they're both about a year old. Okay, we got this one hooked up under load now. And we're letting the voltage drop down. And we'll go ahead and turn this off. We've seen 5.82 peak, which was 75 watts peak. We'll turn it off and see what we can get. Coming up on 76 watts. Alright, we're gonna let this one climb and then come back and see what the peaks were. Alright, as we can see, this panel is also at least 80% efficient after a year. 82.5 was the watts peak. And we're still under a load, so we'll take it off and see what happens. And there we are, almost 85 watts, 85.6, and the other one was 87. So still doing way better than expected, even with degradation, being out in the elements for an entire year. All types of weather. So definitely think these Harbor Freight panels are a steal of a deal. The price did go up though, so if you can find them,
usually they go on sale for about 89 bucks. For 89 bucks with the legs, you can't beat it. The only thing is the SAE connectors, do not like them. You can get them in MC4 adapter, or you can just cut them here and add your own MC4s. But as you can see, these panels are definitely a good buy.
Hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.